हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू अवर चैनल। एंड टुडे वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग द सीरीज ऑफ माइंड मैप फॉर पॉलिटी फ्रॉम द बुक एम लक्ष्मीकांत। एंड द टॉपिक दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे इज अ यूनियन एंड इट्स टेरिटरी। नाउ रिगार्डिंग दिस सीरीज दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द एंटायर लक्ष्मीकांत ऑफ पॉलिटी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ माइंड मैप। एंड दिस माइंड मैप आर वेरी यूजफुल बिकॉज ऑफ टू रीजन। द फर्स्ट, वेन यू गो थ्रू दिस माइंड मैप, okay, before preparation of any lesson, you can get a complete overview of that lesson, and while you are reading, you can clearly understand all these concepts. And the second reason is that during the revision time, because we have very less time for the revision, so during the revision time, the mind map are also very beneficial. Thus, this series will be more beneficial for you. So let's start our today's discussion on union and its territory. Starting with the history, okay, as you know that Indian Independence Act was created in year 1947, okay, this act was created in 1947, and this act lead that the India should be divided, or the provinces should be divided in two independence domain, that is the India Pakistan. And at that time, as you know that there were various princely state in India, and we have nearly 552 princely state, okay. And this act of 1947 give the option to the princely state that they can either join India, Pakistan, or they can remain independent. And 549 out of 552 princely state join India, but the three main princely state, that is Hyderabad, Junagadh and Kashmir, refused to join India, okay. But over a period of time, these three places also joined India. Hyderabad joined India by the means of a police action. When the police action took place in Hyderabad, it joined India. Later, the Junagadh joined India by the means of a referendum, okay. By the means of a referendum, when the referendum took place in Junagadh, at that time it joined India. And the third where it is Kashmir, okay. Kashmir joined India when signing the instrument of accession was signed, and thus the Kashmir joined India. In this way, various princely state come and joined India. Now, regarding the commissions that were formed during the reorganization of a state, as you know that various states, that is princely states, were integrated and joined India. At that time, the arrangement of that states was not permanent basis, okay. There were various demand from the region. Particularly at that time, the South Indian region was demanding that the reorganization of a state should be done on the linguistic basis, that is language basis, the state should be reorganized. Thus, the government of India at that time in year 1948, they form a commission known as a Dhar Commission. Okay, the chairman was the S.K. Dhar, thus it is known as a Dhar Commission. And this commission recommended its report in year 1948 and said that the state should be reorganized in the form of a administrative basis rather than the linguistic basis. Okay, the linguistic basis idea was rejected by the Dhar Commission, but the people were not satisfied, and thus this gave rise to the new commission, okay, that is the JVP Commission. The JVP Commission, why? Because it consists of a three member, that is Jawaharlal Nehru, Vallabhai Patel and Pattabhi Sitaramaiah. Okay, these were the three popular leader at that time, and thus this commission is known as, or this committee is known as a JVP committee. And this committee submitted its report in year 1948, and this committee also reject the idea of a reorganization of a state on the basis of a language. Okay, Dhar Commission and the JVP Commission also reject the idea of a reorganization of a state in the form of a linguistic basis. But in year 1953, government of India was forced to form its first linguistic state, that is Andhra state was formed by separating a Telugu speaking area from a Madras state, and this was formed due to the prolonged popular agitation and the death of a Potti Siramulla. Okay, he was a Congress person who was standing after a 56 day hunger strike for the death of okay we can say that the person that is Potti Shiramula after the 56 day of a hunger strike demanding for a linguistic basis state led to his death, and thus the government was forced to form a first language based state, that is Andhra state was formed. Further, as the Andhra state was formed on the language basis, the other region started to demand for a language basis state, and thus this led to the formation of a state reorganization commission by the head, that is chairman Faisal Ali, okay, and thus it is known as a Faisal Ali commission. And this commission accept the idea of a language, okay, he accept the idea of a language basis for the reorganization of a state, but he reject the idea of a one language one state, okay, he reject the idea of a one language one state. And he state that while accounting or while considering the reorganization of a state, the four criteria should be identified, okay. And what were the four criteria? The first criteria is unity and security of the country, okay, by preservation and strengthening of a unity and security of a country. The second is a linguistic and a cultural homogeneity, okay, by considering the linguistic and the cultural homogeneity, the state should be reorganized. The second is financial, economy and administrative consideration, okay, these three factors should be considered while reorganization of a state. And the fourth one is welfare of a state, okay, while planning and while considering the reorganization, the main motive, that is welfare of a people, should be considered while the state reorganization, okay. These were the four factors that a Faisal Ali commission has recommended, okay. Now what were the articles regarding the union of a state? Okay, the union and its territory, okay, union and its territory deals with the article 1 to 14, okay, 1 to 4, which are the part, okay, which belongs to the part first of the constitution, okay, deals with the union and its territory, okay. There are four articles, starting with the first article, okay. First article describe that India, that is a Bharat, as a union of a state rather than the federation of a state, okay, that is India, or we can say that a Bharat, okay, is considered to be the union of a state rather than the federation, okay. Then why union of a state? There were two reasons, okay, because according to the Dr. Ambedkar, okay, Dr. Ambedkar give a reason why it is known as union of a state, because Indian state, okay, Indian federation is not a result of any agreement among the states, okay, because the state that are in the India, okay, that are not formed due to any agreement, okay. As you know that in American federation, okay, America, their state have a power that they can secede, okay, they can get out of the union, okay, but Indian state do not have a power that they can go out of the Indian federation. Thus it is known as a union of a state rather than a federation of a state, or we can say that it is considered to be the union of a state has preferred to the federation of a state, okay. And thus article 1 deals with a basic three factor, that is name and territory of a union, that is state, union territories and acquired territories, okay. This three part, that is article 1 tells that any territory in India basis on a three part, okay, that is it can be the territory of a state, okay, second is a union territory, or the territory which can India acquire in a course of a time, okay, any new territory if it acquired, it is also become the part of India, that is given in the article number 1. The second is article 2, okay. Article 2 deals with the admission or establishment of a new state, okay. Article 2, that new admission, okay, new admission of any new state or establishment of a new state deals with the article number 2. Now regarding the third article, okay, article number 3, this article gives a power to the parliament, okay, it gives a power to the parliament. And what are the power? The first is that the parliament has a power to form a new state by separating separation or uniting two or more state parts territory to the part. Okay, that parliament can form any new state. Okay, and how it can form the new state? By separating or uniting two or more state. Okay, and it can form a new state by increasing the area. Parliament has power to increase the area of any state, decrease the area of any state after boundaries. Okay, what are the it is alter the boundary of any state, altering the boundary of any state and altering the name of any state. Okay, these are the power given to the parliament according to the article 3. Okay, then how you can remember these points? Okay, there is and one shortcut, that FIDA. Okay, F I D A, F I D A A. Okay, FIDA. Okay, while what belongs to the, what are the provision in the article 3, you can learn it while this short form. Okay, FIDA, that is formation of a new state and separation of a union territory, increase in area, decrease in area, alter the boundaries and alter the name. Okay, now regarding the last article dealing with the union and its territories. Okay, that is according to the article 4. Okay, fourth article of Indian Constitution deals that any law that is made under the article 2 and 3 to provide for the amendment of the first and the fourth schedule and supplement incidental and consequential matter. Okay, this is the article 4. Okay, I am going to explain in very short form that this article 4 state that any the amendment, okay, while we are reorganization in the any state, okay, while we are altering the boundaries or while we are making any laws, okay, any laws in the article 2 and article 3, any laws made in the article 2 and article 3 are not considered to be the amendment of a constitution. Okay, as you know that the amendment in the constitution deals with the article number 368. Okay, so the any law, okay, related to the altering the boundary or related to the any law which is belong to the second article and third article, okay, this should not consider as an amendment in the constitution, because the as you know that amending the constitution need a special majority, and while reorganization or making the law related to the state, it is passed by the simple majority. Thus we can consider that any amendment made in this article, that is article 4 and article 3, is not considered to be the constitutional amendment. In this way we conclude the fourth article, and hence we get a complete overview in the form of a mind map of the union and its territory. And if you are new in our channel, then please do like, comment and subscribe. Have a nice day. Thank you.